Hey guys, welcome back to another video. And it's been so long since I made my last video. I want to get back into uploading again, which would be really cool because I have some really interesting ideas. I want to maybe build a graphics card in real life, maybe something to do with AI or analog computers. But anyway, back to the video. Over the last two videos, as you know, I designed a graphics card and I added features to it such as shading and I increased its speed. And this video was originally supposed to be programming Snake onto the graphics card, but that was too complicated for the graphics card. First of all, the graphics card was too slow, and second of all, I had no CPU to work with the graphics card. So I would have just had to completely redesign the graphics card just to run one game on it, which, you know, it's not really efficient. But maybe in the future, I'll make some sort of CPU along with a graphics card, and I could hook them up together and have them run some games. This will be the final video of this version of the graphics card, the 200X 3D. So I decided it would be something not performance based, but something that will make it easier to use the graphics card, which is something I haven't really been thinking about lately. And this shows because currently to draw a shape on the graphics card, you need to grab a piece of paper, you need to draw out all the points, you need to come up with numbers, you need to think about it a lot, you need to calculate everything. And in the end, it might not even look good. So to fix that, my plan was to create this program which would let you draw or at least preview the object you wanted to render. You could then press a button and have the data be automatically generated to be sent out to the graphics card. So with my video idea now decided, it's time to get to work. I decided to use Python for this program because I knew Python well, and the programs I already used to send data to the graphics card were in Python anyway. So it just makes sense because I wouldn't want to be writing completely new code for this. So the first idea for the app was to have buttons in a grid. You can then just press the buttons to fill in a pixel on the preview and draw whatever shape you'd like. So I started by making this 3x3 square of buttons, which I then tried to extend to a 64x64 grid, just like my graphics card has. But even with the buttons as small as they could be, it was super laggy and it almost crashed my PC. You were definitely not supposed to use Python this way. So I decided to scrap that plan and I set up the UI to have a row of two buttons on one side. And I decided to sort everything in my UI into little sections so we could keep it clean. I added this black square to represent the graphics card's output, and I tried to make it scale to the user's screen size, but that was too complex, so I just set it to a set size of 500 by 500 pixels and set a set window size. Next, I tried to add some text, but I kept getting these weird errors. And once I did get it to work, the text just did not want to go where I needed it to. Somehow it ended up even in the preview, which is just crazy. I don't know how that's possible. So I fixed the text position and I made it say insert point. And I also added this text box input, but I was still having issues with the positioning. But luckily I managed to get that fixed. You're probably wondering, what am I planning to do here? Well, my new plan was to have an input where you could just write the coordinates of the point you wanted to plot. You could just press plot and the screen would display that pixel. This system would be a lot better than having a bunch of buttons just crash your PC. I decided to split it into two smaller text box inputs because it would be a lot easier to type out two numbers instead of writing an entire point using parentheses and a comma every single time. I added this X label, and so it turns out it's really hard to position stuff in Python UI because you can't really give it a position to be in. You have to like pick like, do you want it to be on the north side, the west side? Just, you have to pick a wall for it to stick to or within its little section. And that just makes it a lot harder than it already is. But anyway, I added this Y label and I put them vertically on top of each other and aligned them with the text box inputs. I did some more position fixing and I managed to fix it. I added this plot button and I connected it to a function, which would take the X and Y values from the text boxes and display it in this little pop-up. So now we know that we can collect data from these text boxes. I managed to get pixels plotted onto the preview using the plot button and the text boxes as the coordinates. This took a little bit of time to figure out because the preview was 500 by 500 pixels while the graphics card's output was 64 by 64 pixels. So I had to scale the coordinates up by this value for it to fit inside of the 500 by 500 pixel preview. I had to do some idiot proofing, so I added this error message if both values were empty. I added this error message if it was below or above the minimums and maximums for the coordinates. And I added this information label for later, so the user knows what is happening. So right now, plotting a cube point by point would take a while. So I decided that having the user plot 2 points and then just telling the graphics card to calculate a line between the 2 points would be a lot easier. So I added this create line function, and I thought about how it can be connected to the plot function. I tried to use the information label to help the user and tell him when to input the first point of the line and then the second point of the line, but it was a little buggy and it was glitching, so I decided not to use it for now. And I made it store the points into these two variables. But the issue was is that I kept getting this error with accessing the point ASAT variable inside of the plot function. And I decided to remove the information label for now because I thought it was causing the error. But it didn't do anything, and the real solution was to use the global label on the variables, which according to my researchers, you know, it's not very good, but it'll work, you know. Next, we can use the existing Bresenham's algorithm function I have in the code to calculate and save a line into a list called points AB. But when I tried to use this function to draw lines on the preview, it for some reason wasn't drawing because of an error. So the solution here again was to use the global label on all the variables, which I guess is the simple solution here. And we can now draw a line. I decided to add a label here for user friendliness that would show all the saved points. I tried drawing more lines and the correct value was displayed on the information label, so far so good. And now it was time to implement the shaded planes in the triangles, so I expanded the label to display 4 points. I also adjusted the screen size to fit the bigger label. I started by making this create plane function and variables for the C and D points. But here's when I ran into this big problem. Whenever I would try to enter a value into the 4 points, it would just keep breaking. And even though only one out of the 3 variables was being set, on the label it appeared that all 4 variables were being set to the same thing as the first variable. The solution was to check for if point D was set, then go to point C, then go to point B, then go to point A. Because if you start checking from point A, then it's going to be like, point A is true, so let's move on to point B. And it's going to keep going to point D, and then it's just going to be filled with the same value. So with that fixed, I moved on, and I tried to draw a shaded plane on the preview, but that didn't work for some reason. So I did some debugging. I tried to see how I could display the plane onto the preview, but I didn't really figure it out yet, so I decided to switch gears and work on the UI a little bit. I changed the names of the buttons. I added this color picker button because I wanted to have different color shapes on the preview. And I disabled the buttons I didn't finish yet to make it look cleaner. I also added a color section to the information label, and I again had to resize the screen to fit everything. I made the color picker button open a color picking menu, which was default in Python, where you could select a color and it would be saved into the program. Then all I had to do was set the color of the drawn pixel to the color saved in the variable, and I could create multicolored lines. I also made the create line function save the line into a hex file when the program closed. But that was broken for some reason. I guess I gotta do some more debugging again. And it turns out that the program had duplicate code, and there were two fangs drawing to the hex file at the same time. So I had to comment out the original shape that the graphics card was drawing, or it was trying to draw, before I could draw the line on my graphics card, and it worked this time. But we still had the shaded plane object to fix, so I spent like an hour or two trying to fix that, and I managed to fix it, but the preview and what the graphics card actually showed was always a little bit different, because I think the graphics card worked a bit differently than how I displayed the pixels on my preview. You could just see how tired I was. Look how badly I misspelled Logisim over here. But instead of going down the rabbit hole of making the shaded plane preview actually similar to the graphics card's output, I did what any programmer would do, and instead of actually fixing the problem, I just added a label onto the UI that said preview may not always be accurate. Next, I tried to draw an incorrect shaded plane where there were more pixels on one side than the other side, which obviously wouldn't work. And just made me realize that this feature was kind of useless because you could only draw it as a square and you couldn't do different types of planes. So I just decided to leave it because having the ability to draw a square is better than having no ability to draw no square. So I moved on to the triangle, and I thought the preview was a little bit weird because it looked nothing like a triangle. So I decided to export the output into the graphics card, and I thought, okay, maybe it's again an issue of the preview and the graphics card's output not matching. But this time, the preview was actually accurate, and the reason it wasn't working was because there was never a shaded triangle function in the first place. I think I tried making it before, but I just never finished it, and I just left the function there. And then now I just pick it up and I'm like, oh, I can implement this into my UI. But it was never finished, so I just decided to disable the button and leave it. Maybe I'll do it in the future. Next, it was time to do a little bit of work on the graphics card itself. Here I had a ROM where it would either be a 1 or a 0, it was a 1-bit storage. And this would basically be for the border of the shape, because for some of the shaded objects, they would look weird without a border. So I'd use this to make the border slightly darker than the inside, so it would look more 3D. But I felt like I didn't really need this anymore, so I decided to increase the storage from 1 bit to 24 bits. And now colors can be transmitted from my program into the hex file, then into the program ROM, and then it connects straight to the display. And now we can have different color lines. It finally works. This is the completed Turtle Card 200X 3D. I'll have the GitHub updated in the description after I clean it up a bit. Make sure to join my Discord server, subscribe if you haven't already, and thanks for watching, and hopefully I'll do my next video soon.